Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be talking about the health check within Salesforce. So let's go ahead and go to the cog and hit setup. From here, we're going to type in health check. Double click. And here we go. It'll come up with our standard baseline score. So how this is calculated is based upon the different security factors that we have set into place in our Salesforce org. And then it will come up with a list of recommendations for things that we can do better within our org to make it more secure, and the different things that they check. So we have high risk, low risk, and medium risk things. So a lot of these different things up at the top is the VisualForce pages and headers that session settings need to be set. And it shows us that we have some critical things that we need to set. We also have maximum invalid login attempts. I like to set it at 5, but they like to have it be set at 3. As far as Salesforce goes, that's their recommendation. Some of these things, like the maximum invalid login attempts, that's just going to be security, personal, or org-wide preference. Some may choose to have 5, some 3, others you can have unlimited. It just depends on your risk tolerance as a company as far as your security goes. But again, our score for this org is going to be 74%. As we scroll down, we'll see the different things that they do check and our compliance with it. These are all high risk security settings. And then we scroll down, we find the medium risk security settings. We could choose a minimum password lifetime, enforce IP ranges. These two things are going to be risk tolerance, personal preference, passwords expire days, password history, different session settings. Then we have low risk settings. We can obscure the secret answer, require identity verification, remote site settings, lockout effective period. We can change these once, if we hit edit, it'll take us to the specific tool. So if we wanted to go in and change our invalid login attempts, we'd be able to go click on the edit and then change our invalid login attempts from 5 to 3, save, go back to the health check, refresh the page, and our score should go up a little bit. Yes, it did go up to 77%. So you may or may not see the health check on a few different exams, namely admin, advanced admin, and any security related Salesforce exams. This is just a basic overview on how to check your security settings, see if there are any places that your system might be vulnerable to attacks or security issues. Depending on your risk tolerance, this may be lower or higher depending on the org. Let's say if you were a government organization, your risk tolerance would be very low, versus if you were a smaller startup, then your risk tolerance may be very high. So that is a quick overview. Thank you so much for joining me. If you have any questions, be sure to drop them down below in the description and I will try to get back to you as soon as possible. Check out the courses down below. If you want to subscribe to the email list, you can do so at salesforceemily.com. And I'll catch you guys in the next one.